Namaste, welcome to the online class. Dear students, in the last class we have solved some problems using De Morgan's theorems. Now we shall solve the problems using algebraic method. First problem, prove that x into x plus y is equal to x. LHS is x into x plus y. Now multiply x plus y by x. X into x plus x into y. In the next step we have x into x. X into x plus x into y. X into y. According to idempotence law, x plus x is equal to x. X plus x is equal to x. And x into x is equal to x. According to idempotence law, x into x is equal to x plus x into y. Now, in these two terms, x is the common variable, so write it outside the bracket. So, within the bracket, in the place of x, we have 1 plus y. X is removed out of the bracket, okay? Next step, x into 1 plus y. According to property of 1, 1 plus x is equal to 1. Here the variable is y, so 1 plus y is 1. According to property of 1, 1 into x is x. That is equal to RHS. So given problem is x into x plus y is equal to x. LHS x into x plus y. Multiply x plus y by x. X into x plus x into y. Next, according to idempotence law, x plus x is equal to x plus xy. Next, in these two terms, x is the common variable. So within the bracket, 1 plus y. Next, x into, according to property of 1, 1 plus x is equal to x. 1 plus y is equal to 1. Again, according to property of 1, 1 into x is equal to x. That is equal to RHS. Second problem. Prove algebraically that xy plus xy bar is equal to x. Xy plus xy bar is equal to x. Write the LHS. LHS is equal to xy plus xy bar. Now, in these two terms, x is the common variable. So, write it outside the bracket. Within the bracket, we have y plus y bar. Y plus y bar. Because x is the common variable. Now, x into y plus y bar. According to complementary law, x plus x bar is equal to 1. X plus x bar is equal to 1. And x into x bar is equal to 0. So according to complementary law, y plus y bar is 1. According to property of 1, 1 into x. 1 into x is x. That is equal to RHS. Next, third problem, prove algebraically that y into x plus y bar is equal to x. X plus y into x plus y bar is equal to x. Write the LHS. LHS is equal to x plus y into x plus y bar. Now multiply x plus y bar by x plus y, that is x into x, next x into y bar plus x into y bar, next multiply x by y, y into x, or we can also write it as x into y plus y into y bar, y into y bar. According to idempotence law, x into x is x plus xy plus xy bar plus xy plus y into y bar. According to complementary law, y into y bar is 0, or x into x bar is 0. Here the variable is y, so y into y bar is 0. Next step is, in these three terms, x is the common variable, so write it outside the bracket. So inside the bracket we have 1 plus y bar plus y, because x is the common variable we have taken outside the bracket, plus 0. Next, x into 1 plus y bar. What is 1 plus x? According to property of 1, 1 plus x is equal to 1. Here the variable is y bar, so 1 plus y bar is 1. 1 plus y. Next step, x into, what is 1 plus y? According to property of 1, 1 plus x is 1. 1 into x, or x into 1 is x, that is equal to RHS. Next problem. Prove algebraically that x plus y into x plus z is equal to x plus yz. X plus yz. Write the LHS. LHS is equal to x plus y into x plus z. Now multiply x plus z by x plus y, that is x into x plus x into z plus y into x, that is yx or xy plus y into z. Okay. According to idempotence law, x into x is x, x plus xz plus xy plus yz. In these three terms, x is a common variable, so we can write it outside the bracket. So within the bracket, 1 plus z plus y plus yz. X into 1 plus z. What is 1 plus z? According to property of 1, 1 plus z is 1. 1 plus z is 1 plus yz. Again, according to property of 1, 1 plus y is 1 plus yz. Next, 1 into x. 1 into x is x plus yz. X plus yz, that is equal to RHS. Next problem. Prove that A plus A bar B, A plus A bar B is equal to A plus B. A plus A bar B is equal to A plus B. Now we can expand this using second distributive law. I hope you all remember second distributive law, that is x plus y into z. What is x into y into z? X plus y into z is equal to x plus y into x plus z. X plus y into z is equal to x plus y into x plus z. Now we can assume a as x, a bar as y, b as z. Now this is in the form of second distributive law. Write the LHS. LHS is equal to a plus a bar b. We have assumed a as x, a bar as y, b as z. Now according to the law, x plus y, what is x? A is x. So a plus y, a bar is assumed as y, so a plus a bar, a plus a bar into x plus z. What is x? A plus z, z is b. According to complementary law, x plus x bar is equal to 1, or a plus a bar is equal to 1, 1 into a plus b. Now if you assume a plus b as x, 1 into x, according to property of 1, 1 into x is x. Now 1 into a plus b is a plus b, that is equal to RHS. Next problem. Prove that a bar plus ab, a bar plus ab is equal to a bar plus b. A bar plus ab is equal to a bar plus b. Now write the LHS. LHS is equal to a bar plus ab. If we assume a bar as x, a as y, b as z, then we can expand this using second distributive law, that is x plus y into z is equal to x plus y into x plus z. According to second distributive law, x plus y, what is x? A bar plus y is a, into x plus z. X is a bar plus z is b. According to complementary law, a plus a bar is 1 into a bar plus b. If we assume a bar plus b as x, 1 into x is x, 1 into x, that is a bar plus b, that is a bar plus b, that is equal to RHS. Next we shall see the derivation of Boolean expressions. Derivation of under that literals. Literals means Boolean expression consists of single variable or its complement. It is called as literal. For example, x, y bar, z, these are called literals. For example, in the Boolean expression, say x, y bar plus y, z. In this expression, there are four literals: x, y bar, y, and z. So, literals are the variables with the bar or the variables without bar. Boolean expression consists of single variable or its complement is called literals. Next, minterms. Let us write the definition of minterms. It is very, very important. Product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. Called minterms. Product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. So, what is literal? Literal is a variable or its complement. Product of all the literals. For example, x, y, z bar. So, here x, y, z bar is minterm because here you can see product of all the literals. In this example, there are three literals. They are x, y, and z bar. And we have multiplied x with y and z. X, y, z bar. Let us consider another example. Say y, z bar. Here, in this example, you can see two literals. Y literal and z bar literal. Or x bar, y bar, z bar. Here x bar, y bar, z bar are called minterms because product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. First variable is complemented, second literal is also complemented, third literal is also complemented. In the first example, third literal is complemented. That is minterms. Minterms means product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. Next, we shall see the truth table for minterms. Truth table for minterms. That is two input truth table. Yes, two inputs are x, y, x and y. Next, minterm. In this column, we are going to write the minterm or product terms. Yes, if there are two variables, then four combinations of zeros and ones. That is 0, 0, 1, 1. In the second column, 0, 1, 0, 1. Yes, let us write the minterm. See, in minterms, for a variable with 0, for a variable with value 0, that variable is complemented. See, here in the first row, value of the variable x is 0 means you have to write the complement of that variable, that is x bar. Next, y. Y is having the value 0. For a variable with value 0, you have to complement the variable y bar. Now, this is the minterm for the first row, that is 0, 0. Next, in the second row, value of x is 0. So, here, write the complement of x, that is x bar. And value of y is 1. If the value of the variable is 1, then multiply the variable as it is. That is y. Next, in the third row, value of x is 1, so write as it is. Value of y is 0, so write the complement of y bar. Next, in the fourth row, both the variables are having the value 1, so write as it is, that is x, y. This is the truth table for minterms, that is 2 input truth table. If there are 2 inputs, then there should be 4 combinations of zeros and ones, 2 zeros, 2 ones. In the next column, 0, 1, 0, 1. And how to find out minterm for a variable with value 0? Write the complement of the variable. Here x and y both are having value 0, so write the complement of those variables, x bar and y bar. In the second row, value of x is 0, so write the complement of x. Value of y is 1, multiply as it is. In the third row, value of x is 1, value of y is 0, so write x as it is and complement y. And in the fourth row, both the variables are having value 1, so write as it is, x, y. Next, let us draw the truth table for minterms, that is 3 input truth table. So, minterm means product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. See, here x bar y bar, x bar y, x y bar, x y are the minterms, because product of all the literals. See, in the first row, product of the literals. Literals are x bar and y bar. Minterm is x bar into y bar. In the second row, x bar y. Here, x bar and y are the literals. Here, you can see the product of the literals. In the third row, x, y bar. Here, product of the literals, x and y bar. Next, in the fourth row, x, y. X, y are the literals and we have written the product of x, y. Okay, now 3 input truth table. Truth table for minterms, that is 3 input. Dear students, we know that if there are 3 inputs, then 8 combinations of zeros and ones, x, y, z. X, y, z are the 3 inputs. Then we have to write the minterms for those inputs. For 3 variables, 8 combinations of zeros and ones. Yes, 4 zeros, then 4 ones. In the second column, 2 zeros, 2 ones, 2 zeros, 2 ones. In the third column, 0 1, 0 1, 0 1, 0 1. Now, how to write the minterms? Let us consider the first row. In the first row, all the 3 variables are having value 0. We know that for a variable with value 0, we need to find out the complement. We need to write the complement of the variable, that is x bar into y bar into z bar. In the second row, value of x is 0, so write the complement of x. Value of y is 0, again complement of y. Here value of z is 1, so multiply as it is. In the third row, value of x is 0, y is 1, z is 0, so complement of x, y, multiply y as it is, because value of y is 1. Next, z, z bar. Next, fourth row, 0, 1, 1, that is x bar y z. Next, fifth row, 1, 0, 0, x, y bar, z bar. Next, sixth row, 1, 0, 1, x, y bar, z. Seventh row, 1, 1, 0, x, y, z bar. Next, last row, all the variables are having value 1. So write as it is, x into y into z. These are all min terms. What are min terms? Product of all the literals with or without bar. So these are the product of the literals. They are called min terms. Okay. Next, we shall see shorthand min term notation or min term designation. Shorthand minterm notation or minterm designation. Let us find out the minterm designation for x bar y z. X bar y z. So variable with the bar denotes 0. Variable with bar denotes 0. Here there is no complement for the second variable, so it denotes 1. Next, third variable is z, that is variable without bar, which denotes 1. Now convert 0, 1, 1 to decimal form, that is 0 into 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0. We have studied this in the first PUC. Now we are converting 0, 1, 1 to decimal equivalent, that is 1 into 2 to the power 0. Here 1 into 2 to the power 1. Here 0 into 2 to the power 2, 0 into 2 to the power 2, that is 0 into 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0. 0 into 2 to the power 2 is 4 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 is 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0 is 1, that is 0 plus 2 into 1 is 2 plus 1 into 1 is 1, 2 plus 1, 3. So shorthand minterm notation of x bar y z, x bar y z is m3. Here we use lowercase m or small letter m to represent a minterm designation, that is m3. Let us find out the shorthand minterm designation for x y bar z bar. So x is a variable without bar, so it denotes 1. Y is a variable with bar, which denotes 0. Z is a variable with bar, so its value is 0. 1, 0, 0. Now convert 1, 0, 0 to decimal form, that is 1 into 2 to the power 2 plus 0 into 2 to the power 1 plus 0 into 2 to the power 0. That is 1 into 2 to the power 2, 1 into 2 to the power 2 plus 0 into 2 to the power 1 plus 0 into 2 to the power 0, that is equal to 2 to the power 2, that is 4, 4 into 1, 4 plus 2 to the power 1 is 2, 2 into 0 is 0 plus 2 to the power 0 is 1, so 0 into 1, that is also 0. So finally we get the answer 4, that is m4. That is about shorthand minterm notation or minterm designation. So minterms are product of all the literals with or without bar within the logic system. Next, canonical expression. numerical expression means Boolean expression composed of either of the min terms or max terms, then it is called as canonical expression. Boolean expression composed of either min terms or max terms. For example, x, y, z plus x, y bar, z plus x bar, y bar, z bar. This is the canonical expression. Canonical expression composed of min terms. Here you can see three min terms. They are x, y, z, x, y bar, z, x bar, y bar, and z bar. So canonical expression is Boolean expression composed of either of the min terms or max terms. There are two types of canonical expressions. They are canonical SOP expression. SOP means sum of product expression. Sum of product expression and canonical POS expression. Canonical POS expression, that is product of sum expression. Two types of canonical expressions are canonical sum of product expression or canonical SOP expression, canonical POS expression or canonical product of sum expression. Here, canonical sum of product expression deals with min terms. Canonical product of sum deals with max terms. So we shall see the definition of canonical sum of product expression. Canonical SOP expression. If the Boolean expression is represented as sum of min terms, then the expression is said to be in canonical SOP form. Canonical SOP form. This is the definition of canonical SOP expression. If the Boolean expression is represented as sum of the min terms, then the expression is said to be in canonical SOP form. Let us consider the expression x, y, z plus x, y bar, z plus x bar, y bar, z bar. Now, this is in the form of canonical sum of product form. See, canonical sum of product means Boolean expression represented as a sum of the min terms. See, here x, y, z is the min term, x, y bar, z is the min term, x bar, y bar, z bar is the min term, and it is represented as sum of the min terms, sum of the three min terms. So that is an example for canonical SOP form. Canonical SOP expression means if the Boolean expression is represented as sum of min terms, then the expression is said to be in the canonical SOP form. This expression is in canonical SOP form. Let us consider another expression. Say A bar B bar C plus A B C bar plus A B C. Here you can see three min terms and they are represented as sum of the min terms. See here, a bar b bar c plus a b c bar plus a b c. This is canonical SOP expression. That is sum of the product expression. Sum of the product. Canonical POS expression deals with the max term. We'll study that later. There are two methods to derive canonical SOP expression. First method, truth table method. Second method is algebraic method. Truth table method and algebraic methods are used to derive canonical SOP expression. Let us see how to derive canonical SOP expression using truth table method. A logical network has two inputs, x and y, and output z. The relationship between input and output is to be as follows. That is, x equal to 0, y equal to 0, z is equal to 1. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, z is equal to 0. Next, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, z is equal to 1. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 1. Draw the truth table. And write SOP expression. Now we shall draw the truth table and SOP expression. Yes, in the question, it's given that there are two inputs. Inputs are x and y. So, for two inputs, four combinations of zeros and ones. Inputs are x, y, and it is given that output is z. Output is z. And here, we need to write min term. And values of x, y, z are given. In the first row, value of x is 0, y is 0, z is 1. In the second row, x is 0, y is 1, z is 0. In the third row, x is 1, y is 0, z is 1. And in the fourth row, x 1, y 1, z 1. Now, write the min terms, x, y, z. X is the variable having the value 0. For a variable with value 0, that variable is complemented. So x bar, next value of y is 0, complement the variable y. Next z value is 1, multiply as it is. In the second row, the values of x, y, z are 0, 1, 0. So x bar, value of y is 1, multiply as it is, value of z is 0, complement the variable. In the third row, 1, 0, 1. So x, value of y is 0, complement the variable, value of z is 1, multiply as it is. And in the fourth row, all the variables are having the value 1. So x, y, z, x, y, z, these are the main terms. Now let us write the SOP expression. SOP expression. Now add all the min terms for which the output is 1. Add all the min terms for which the output is 1. Here in the first row you can see the output 1, that is for the min term x bar, y bar, z, the output is 1. And in the second row output is 0, so don't write this min term. Next, in the third row output is 1 for the min term x, y bar, z. Next, in the last row 1 is the output for the min term x, y, z. Now add all the min terms with output 1. So x bar, y bar, z is the min term with the output 1. Next, x, y bar, z is the min term with output 1. Then x, y, z is the min term with output 1. So this is the sum of product expression. Sum of products, here you can see the products x bar into y bar into z, and in the second term x into y bar into z, and in the third term x into y into z. So sum of the products, that is sum of product expression. Okay, we will continue in the next class. Thank you.